What strikes you when you think of a city? Its culture? Its people? Its streets? Amidst all the hustle bustle, we often forget the wagging tails and tiny paws that follow us everywhere. They watch us, they guard us, but they also fear us. While these stray animals are seen as a menace by most, there are few who believe in their welfare. One such story is of Darshana, who steps out every morning to feed stray dogs in Vimannagar, Pune. Having lived with farm animals as a child, she grew up to become an animal lover. 6 years ago, Darshana fed her first dog, and since then, she hasn't looked back. From one dog, she went on to feed 200 in a day. All this for a cause larger than just feeding. A cause that serves both the people and the strays.
What motivated you to start feeding strays in and around Oman?
So first thing is I was very upset at seeing, you know, very malnourished dogs around. And when I realized that there is a solution, and getting them sterilized is the best thing to do. Like if you go to South Bombay, you'll hardly see any dogs on the streets. So what they've done is they've sterilized all the dogs, so you have a better neighborhood and you don't see animals suffering. And I realized if I wanted to get them sterilized, I needed to feed them to make them friendly enough. So it becomes easier for me to catch them, as well as understand how many dogs there are in each area. Unless you do that, you don't really, you can't be sure how many dogs there are.
In India, sterilization was started in 2001 as a part of the Animal Birth Control Initiative. It has been successfully implemented in over 60 cities across the country. Blue Cross Society, a non-profit organization, carries out the most number of sterilization procedures in Pune. Here's what the doctors of Blue Cross Society want the citizens to know.
Sterilization is basically removal of the reproductive organs in dogs and cats. So in females, basically the reproductive organs, which are ovaries and uterus, so these are removed, and in males, the testicles are removed. By sterilization, we can reduce the stray population by preventing the reproduction.
Dog must be in healthy condition, and age criteria is very much important. For male, we can sterilize after 3-4 months. After 3-4 months, according to SOP guidelines, and for female, after 6-7 months, we can they're fit for sterilization. Before they come in first aid, if we go for sterilization, then it will be good for females.
Okay. And sterilization will prevent mammary tumors in females, also the ovarian, because the ovaries and uterus are removed, so the chances of they getting this ovarian tumor or uterus or any problem in the uterus, so that is prevented. And in males, prostatic tumor and prostatic hyperplasia, so many other diseases which are related to the reproductive organs can be prevented by sterilization. After sterilization, the fights among the males are reduced, because females don't come into heat. So thereby we can prevent the dog fights, and thus we can prevent the spread of rabies in animals as well as in humans. So during sterilization, anti-rabies vaccination is also given for them. So thereby we can reduce the population as well as control rabies in the society.
With a stray population of 70,000 dogs in Pune, Blue Cross has consistently increased the number of sterilization cases. In 2013, 4,500 dogs were sterilized, after which it went up to 7,000 dogs in the year 2014, and 8,000 dogs were sterilized in 2015.
Despite increasing efforts of sterilization by organizations like Blue Cross Society and the Pune Municipal Corporation, some people still think of strays as a menace. Some even going to the extent of abusing these animals. It is because of this insensitive attitude that people like Darshana face a lot of challenges.
So the first thing was I went to a slum area because I saw an extremely malnourished dog over there, and she was in heat. It was really sad when I saw her. And I started feeding her. The slum people over there, they weren't happy about the fact that I was feeding the strays. And when I spoke to them, I realized that they really had issues with, you know, street dogs. The fact is that street dogs take away their slippers, tear their clothes, and they also attack children when they are eating something, little kids, because the stray dogs are hungry. So I explained to them, I said that I want to get them sterilized and I'm feeding them, they won't attack your children, things like that. But still, it was very difficult for them to accept it. Later on, when I got them sterilized, the same people started supporting me. The same guy who had said he wouldn't want me to go and feed over there was so happy he adopted one of the dogs that I'd gotten sterilized. So the challenges are only initial. Unfortunately, it is societies that create the major issues. They are extremely unhappy about, you know, living in coexistence with animals, which is really sad. They just don't want any dogs inside the society. We've had the PMC called many times, and relocation is actually illegal, and still they get it done. So this is really sad. So it is majorly the educated people that cause issues. The challenges are with the society people.
Marda Colony has the largest dog population in Vimalnagar. We spoke to a few locals there, and this is what they had to say.
त्या रस्त्यावरती ते कुत्र्यांमुळं लोकांना खूप त्रास होते, कारण की जे रात्रीचे गाड्या पळतात त्यांना कुत्रे भोगतात आणि त्यांच्या पाठीमागं त्याच्यामुळं ॲक्सिडेंटचं खूप प्रमाण वाढलेलं आहे. आणि रात्री त्याच्यामुळं कुत्र्यांमुळं ॲक्सिडेंट खूप प्रमाण त्याचे ॲक्सिडेंट पण होतात.
I don't think the PMC can do this without the help of citizens. So if we collaborate with the PMC, they will be able to do their job better.
While her mornings are reserved for the dogs who eagerly wait for her, the rest of Darshana's day is spent working as an activist.
And what is it that you and your team are working towards?
So I volunteer with FIAPO, the Federation of Indian Animal Protection Organizations, which is a representative voice of more than 200 NGOs all over India and Living Free is their flagship campaign for farmed animals. So we're raising awareness regarding the animals that we eat. We are so conditioned by society, and this has happened for thousands of years, that it's wrong to hurt a dog and you should love a pet like a cat or a dog. But it's okay to eat a chicken. Oh, that's so pretty. But it's okay to eat chickens or to kill chickens or eat eggs or, you know, exploit cows for dairy or buffaloes for dairy or their meat. So we raise awareness about that to sensitize people about what is actually happening in these industries and the abuse and the cruelty that happens and the basic exploitation that happens. There's another thing that we are doing, it's called India Unites for Animals. This is a totally citizens movement because of the frustration of the law that is so insufficient for what is actually happening because of the cruelty cases that are rising. So we want the Animal Welfare Bill to be passed by Parliament.
Being the Pune Federation Coordinator for Animal Protection Organization, Darshana promotes veganism by distributing pamphlets. She also conducts a video outreach program in various educational institutions across the city. While the city prepares to sleep, Darshana prepares next day's meal for the strays. In a country that sees dogs as a threat, a few people like Darshana remain a ray of hope. She's aware that her struggle to bring change is long and that the obstacles are many. But Darshana has decided to not give up.